Thousands of school children in Greater Boston are discovering a fascinating world that existed millions of years ago. As Terrell Harris reports, their education comes from a new exhibit at Boston's World Trade Center.
Dinosaurs are supposed to be extinct. Scientists say they disappeared from the face of the Earth 65 million years ago. But for some reason, they've come back to life in Boston.
We interrupt this news report to bring you this special bulletin. This is Tyler Grace reporting at the World of Dinosaurs at the World Trade Center in Boston, bringing you back to our reporters, Nat Duca and Sienna Gerson, at WGUS News Studio in Beverly Farms.
Hey, we're on the air.
This is Sienna Gerson, Nat Duca, with a special news report at WGUS.
We have just learned that Miss Rosalind Clark, the incredibly nice third grade teacher at the Glen Urquhart School, is missing.
The rumor is that she's with a man named Mr. Moose.
Unite and unite, now let us unite, for summer is a-coming today. And whither we are going, we all will unite in the merry morning of May.
Our WGUS news team is now on location seeking clues to the whereabouts of Miss Clark.
Jasmine, Dana, and Jay Kavanaugh here at the Glen Urquhart School, Beverly Farms.
We're here with Miss Fox, the other third grade teacher, and Mr. Gray.
Where do you think Miss Clark is?
I think she's in a place far away from here that will take some travel to get to.
And please describe some characteristics of Miss Clark.
Well, let's see. The most important characteristic is that she loves chocolate in almost any form. She also really enjoys reading mystery novels. And she likes to go to plays and theater productions and musical performances. She is a performer herself. She likes adventure and something that uses her imagination.
Miss Fox, what will you miss about Miss Clark?
Well, she had a very wonderful, a special, an extensive wardrobe. It's going to be very hard without her next year, just getting dressed in the morning.
And how do you think things will change without her?
Oh,
with her gone.
The new theme is going to be, where is she going? And I'm very excited about one of those units, the winter one. We're going to be taking an in-depth look at peanut butter. Yeah, I'm excited especially about integrating the math activities with that. We'll be using the peanut and the tablespoon as units of measure in a very new and creative way, I think.
Yeah. Where would you go if you were Miss Clark?
When I think about it, somehow the word moose comes to mind, so I would begin looking in Texas or California.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Thank you.
This is Jasmine Dana and Jake Kavanaugh now returning you to the WGUS studio.
We're now going on location with our reporter, Sophie Beale, who is outside Gus and who is with some undercover detectives looking for clues on where Rosie Clark has gone.
This is Sophie Beale talking and proudly here with Johnny the detective and Morris L. Pippin. How is the investigation going?
Very good.
Have you found any clues?
we have found very mysterious footprints.
Very Miss Clarky footprints.
But we haven't gathered the courage to see where they lead.
Why is that?
Let us show you.
Very interesting.
Wrong species. Listen, animal, what are you doing with Mrs. Clark?
Stick up your paws.
Boss, I think we're on the right track. Raccoon with dinosaur footprints.
I think we're on the wrong track. Back to Sienna and Nat.
WGUS News has just found this book that belongs to Paige Ramsdell, but she's on vacation. Maybe there are some clues inside. Let's look at this page, for example. Flower, spring wedding. Light flowers pop up, the birds start to sing again, a sweet flower girl.
This is Beth Tomich, and I'm here with Paige Ramsdell, who has just returned from a vacation to help with our search for Miss Clark's. Paige, do you have anything new for us?
I just got back from Logan Airport. I was getting my baggage when I saw Miss Clark getting on a plane. She was wearing a scarf and a smile, and I think she was headed west.
In the meantime, we've got a breaking news story from our field reporter, Francis Griffin, who seems to have uncovered some new information on where Mrs. Clark could be.
I'm back inside Glen Urquhart School with Jennifer DeAngelis and Sophie Beale, a famous singing duo who will be singing their new song.
For all you classical music lovers out there, here's your big chance to buy a copy of Sophie and Jen's new album, Greatest Hits of the 60s. Here's a sneak preview of the hit song from their album.
We wrote the song before Miss Clark disappeared. And if you see anyone who fits the description here, will you please call 1-800-542-ROSE.
When we have to say goodbye, when we can think about you in our hearts, where the wild mountain time grows around the blooming heather. Will you stay, Rosie, stay? We will miss you very deeply, like the snowflakes from the heavens, where the wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will you stay, Rosie, stay? When you're out on your great adventure, you'll remember us in your hearts, where the wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will you stay, Rosie, stay? When you have to say goodbye, we can think about you in our hearts, where the wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will you stay, Rosie, stay?
Also included are By Myself, I See Your Face Before Me, and Time After Time. Buy one tape at $19.95 and get one record free. But call now, 1-800-542-ROSE.
Is that one of Rosie's favorites?
Yeah.
It's one of our newest.
Oh, thanks, Jen and Sophie. Now back to you, Sienna and Nat.
We now go to our roving reporter, Sarah Engel, another former student of Miss Clark's.
Thank you. This is Sarah Engel. As you know, Rosie was a great poetry lover. She would often rehearse her poems in her house and in the bathroom and at the school meetings. Today I'm with Erin Deary, a well-known poet and former student of Miss Clark. She will read a poem that she wrote for Mrs. Clark.
Thanks. Miss Clark, roses are red, violets are blue. You're the best teacher, there's no one like you. When I have a math problem, I can count on you. Mix your titles to confuse, but we all know the trick you use. We're glad we had the chance to know you. We'll miss the stories, costumes, and shows. Please use your pen to be my pal. It isn't hard, you know how. Though far away, let's stay in touch. Otherwise, I'll miss you much.
Thank you, Aaron. Also with me today are my fellow reporters, Francis Griffin and Jamie Remington, students of Mrs. Clark's third grade class.
Oh yeah, remember Miss Clark?
Yeah, she's the one who taught us about knights.
But I already knew about knights.
Oh, be quiet. Remember when she taught us about the tundra?
Yeah, with those big, fearsome animals.
Here comes a polar bear.
Thank you, Jamie. Thank you, Francis. We're very sorry about the unexpected visit from the polar bear. As you know, there was a nationwide search going on for the world's greatest third grade teacher, Mrs. Clark. If your son or daughter is an extremely happy third grader, maybe Miss Clark is their teacher. If so, please help us locate her by calling 1-800-542-ROSE. Now back to the studio.
We'll be back with more on our search for Rosie Clark after this brief commercial break.
I'm Alexander Rich, and I just invented this new computer game, Where in the World is Rosalind Clark?
Hey, what's that?
I think it's a computer desk.
Do you want to buy it?
Yeah.
It would look great.
Let's buy it. Give us the money.
Okay, thanks. See, everybody? People all over the world love it, and it just got invented.
Oh, I'm showing the book titles. Oh, this is going to be fun.
We'll be chased of the wolves.
Wolves will be chased.
Okay, now I say what.
Friendly big giant.
Big friendly giant.
Yeah.
See, it's both exciting and educational. What do you think of it, boys?
Cool.
Awesome, it's almost like the real Mrs. Clark.
Okay, to order your copy, call today, 1-800-542-ROSE.
We're back now with our special report on the disappearance of Rosalind Clark. We're now going to our reporter, Jessamine Solomon Greenbaum, who is on location in Texas.
Hello, this is Jessie Solomon Greenbaum in Texas. I'm having an interview with the world's most famous rider, horseback riding instructor, Taylor Sewell. Hello, do you know Miss Rosalind Clark?
Yes, I have known her ever since third grade.
How do you know her?
Well, she used to be my third grade teacher, and when I was in third grade one day, we couldn't find her, so when I grew up, I had totally forgotten about it, and so I decided that I would just go inside to become a riding instructor, and then I heard that she had a lesson with me, so then she didn't show up for her lesson, so my friend and I went pot handling, and we went out, and we found some gold in this river, and if anybody finds her, I will gladly give this to them for a reward.
Well, that's all very interesting. Now you hear that 6 pieces of gold are rewarded for whoever finds Miss Rosalind Clark. I'm also here with Shiloh Hayward, the chief moose identifier in Texas. Now, Shiloh, Miss Fox told us to look for Miss Clark in Texas. Something about moose.
Oh yeah, we got plenty of moose up here. They come walking by here every morning.
Have you ever seen Miss Clark with them?
No, I haven't seen Miss Clark with any moose, but I've seen lots of Mrs. Moose. I'm very late for my doctor's appointment. Gotta go.
So what brings you here today?
Oh, I'm so depressed. I've been dreaming about mooses and cows.
Excuse me.
I'm a reporter from WGUS, and I'd like to ask you a few questions.
All right.
Did you ever have a woman named Rosalind Clark as a patient?
Yes, but I'd have to go look at my files to make sure.
Can you tell me something about her?
Yeah, sure. Hold on. It says here she had a very difficult spelling difficulty. And at least every single day she would make one mistake. She liked scarves and jokes. She was very funny, as I would say.
What type of scarves did she have?
Well, I have one handy right now. This was her second favorite scarf. And,
Can we get on with this doctor's appointment?
You have a late-breaking bulletin that Rosie Clark may be in California.
Let's cut to Olivia Maloney, our West Coast correspondent in San Francisco.
Good evening, Nat. We would like to tell you our story about Mrs. Clark in the Muir Woods.
I just love walking in the Muir Woods.
What's this? I thought there was no litter allowed here.
Let's see. Where does it start? Looks like it's store.
The Adventures of Mrs. Clark in the Muir Woods. Sounds interesting. One day, Mrs. Clark decided to go to Muir Woods all by herself, even though there was a dangerous bear in the clearing. When she got to Muir Woods, there in the clearing was a dangerous bear. Mrs. Clark climbed one of the redwood trees because she was too tired to fight the bear. Luckily, she got a bird's eye view of the forest and the bear. And we think that she is still there now. Oh no, wait. She's having another adventure. At sundown, the bear left, and Mrs. Clark wondered about how she was going to get down. It was dark, so she couldn't climb down from the tree, so she started feeling around. Suddenly, she was falling through a hole in the tree. Crash! She landed with a thump. Before she knew it, birdies were flying over her head because she had landed in the bird home. She climbed out through the bird's hole in the tree. Now she is heading back. We now go back to our regular scheduled program.
Mrs. Clark has just been found, and here's a photo of her.
Hey, did you hear that?
Here's the proof. We have it all. Mrs. Clark is going to San Francisco, marrying Mr. Moose.
We now return to our regular scheduled program.
At least 500,000 people are expected to see this exhibit by its July 24th close date. After all, it will only take about 2 hours to take a trip back to a time before man existed. In Boston, Terrell Harris, The News at 10.
Unite and unite, now let us unite, for summer is a coming today. And whither we are going, we all will unite in the merry morning of May. The young men of past, oh, they might if they would, for summer is a coming today. They might have built a ship and gilded it with gold in the merry morning of May. The young maids have passed, so they would if they might, for summer is a coming today. They might have played the garland, the red rose and the white in the merry morning of May. Unite and unite, now let us unite, for summer is a coming today. And whither we are going, we all will unite.
for summer is a-coming today. Oh, some they are in England, and some they are in France.